You want to support Roller March Unfiltered? Be sure to join our Bring the Funk fan club. Every dollar that you give to us supports our daily digital show. There's only one daily digital show out here that keeps it black and keep it real. It's Roland Martin Unfiltered. Support the Roland Martin Unfiltered daily digital show by going to RolandMartinUnfiltered.com. You can make this possible.
In Los Angeles, Ed Buck appeared in a federal courtroom and pleaded not guilty for the deaths of Gemmel Moore and Timothy Dean. Of course, he was, of course, charged a three additional count of distributing methamphetamine. Buck, of course, is a wealthy Democratic donor, was first charged in federal court in September with providing methamphetamines led to the 2017 overdose death of Gemmel Moore. He was then indicted in connection with Moore's death, as well as the January death of Timothy Dean. His next hearing is scheduled for November 26th. He will remain in custody. He'll be arraigned on Friday in Los Angeles Superior Court on state charges, including operating a drug house. Go to our panel there, Dr. Greg Carr, Chair of the Department of Afro-American Studies, Howard University, Dr. Avis Jones-DeWeaver, political analyst, and also Abisha Cross. She is political commentator and Democratic strategist. I will start with you, Avis. It was public pressure that actually brought this to bear. And what is shameful is that Jackie Lacey, the black district attorney there in Los Angeles County, was not the one to really pursue this. In fact, had this been left up to Jackie Lacey, Ed Buck would now be out of jail because he had the $4 million to meet his bail in state court. Of course, there's no bail on the federal level. And so if it were not for these federal charges, Ed Buck will be back at his home, likely doing the exact same thing.
Chilling, getting away with murder. I mean, it is really unconscionable that it's taken this long. I mean, these are not the first two incidents that he's been involved with in terms of black men showing up dead in his space. And so it's good to see that finally it looks like there will be a measure of justice here. But it's a shame that when left to their own devices, specifically, as you mentioned, at the state level, he would have been able to get away with it once again.
Amisha, again, public pressure matters, and this is why it matters in this case. The protest, shining a light on Ed Buck, the social media, the work of Jasmine Koenig and so many others, us, of course, putting issue on this show. The constant attention is what happened here. But the bottom line is two black men have died as a result of being in Ed Buck's home. This tells you that black lives don't matter, even to a black DA in Los Angeles County.
Absolutely. It tells us that, but it also tells us that even to the LGBTQ organizations that are supposed to be fighting to protect people against this type of predatory behavior, black lives also don't matter. One of the things that we've consistently seen is that among those organizations, the faces are always white LGBTQ members. They are rarely black people in general. And when we see an issue like this, those organizations have largely been silent. Where's human rights? Where are all of these organizations that stand in the intercession for victims of these violent crimes? In Ed Buck's case, I agree, there was so much of a groundswell of individuals across Hollywood who have stepped out and have said, for years, actually, that this is what's happening. And it took a very long time. Two people died. However, there have been dozens more who have almost died or have been held captive and have also been injected with these lethal drugs and have been a part of this secret sex dungeon or not so secret sex dungeon that he's had going on. And I think that this tells us something else about society where everyone knows what's going on and it takes years for any legal charges to actually come up.
Greg Carr. We've often talked about this whole issue that, again, for black folks, if a black woman comes up missing, there has to be protests, there has to be a massive focus put on mass media. The fact that this guy, multimillionaire, using his money to be able to keep his freedom, and again, thank goodness he's arraigned in the federal court, otherwise he would still be out.
Absolutely, and I agree with everything that Dr. Jones-Weaver and also Sis Cross have said. I mean, when we look at this guy, Ed Buck is a former Republican. Of course, he's donated to Democrats now. But this is a story about class. It's about the super elite. This is a man who has supported LGBTQIA causes, but also engages, as we just heard Sister Cross say, in some fairly devious and deviant behavior, but his money shielded him up until now. And then when you see, you know, in our community, just because we happen to be from the same race, when you start disaggregating that by social class, these are some of the most vulnerable people in this society. So these black men who have been read a certain way sexually and in their social class are at the bottom of the pyramid, even so much so as we just heard, that you don't see people advocating for them. And finally, what you have echoed again and again, the fact that this show is one of the few places, along with the people in the streets, that is consistently talking about this. This isn't going to be covered in any way on Eurostream or commercial white media. The fact is that popular pressure is what leads to transformation. And that's always been the case. There's only one weapon you can use against money. That is people. People have to be organized to deal with people who have money.
All right, folks. Again, he's going to be the next court date is in November, so we'll certainly be covering that. And want to thank Jasmine Kane for keeping us updated. She also, of course, posted on her social media account a video of Gemmel Moore's mother and Timothy Dean's sister actually meeting in a restaurant and hugging. Quite emotional. These two black women, of course, in an unfortunate situation, their loved ones dying in Ed Buck's apartment. Both of them, of course, were seeking justice. All right, folks, back to our Roland Martin Unfiltered video in just one moment. Folks, that's my frat, Gerald Law, right there. We're going to be in Cabo November 7th through the 11th for the second annual Life Luxe Jazz Experience. It's an unbelievable lineup of folks there. 14 different acts, including Gerald Albright, Alex Bunyan, Raul Madan, Shalea, Roy Ayers, Ernest Quarles, Johnny McClurkin. It's going to be an unbelievable gathering there. Of course, if you want to be able to go, go to lifeluxjazz.com, LifeLuxeJazz.com. But if you can't make it there, you can still get your live stream pass courtesy of GFNTV.com. That's GFNTV.com. Live stream pass, $10.99. You'll get access to all 3 days, 14 different acts performing at the Life Luxe Jazz Festival. And again, the website you want to go to is GFNTV.com. Would love for you to check it out. I'll be broadcasting Roland Martin Unfiltered from there on Thursday and Friday. And again, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, you can check out all of the fantastic concerts there at the second annual Life Luxe Jazz Experience, LifeLuxeJazz.com. And of course, to get the live stream pass, GFNTV.com. Now back to your Roland Martin Unfiltered video.